Hello students, we are in final accounts. In the previous class I taught you what is final accounts means, its introduction, objectives and format of trading account. In this video I will explain the second component of trading account, that is profit and loss account, along with its format. Profit and loss account is an account or statement which is prepared to ascertain the net profit or net loss, which is finally transferred to capital account while preparing the balance sheet. So this profit and loss account covers all indirect expenses and all indirect incomes, means all kinds of transactions, whether expenses or income, which are incurred at the office level or brought into one account, that is called as profit and loss account. So the result, as I told you earlier, the result is a net profit or net loss. If we get the net profit, then we are supposed to add that net profit to capital account while preparing the balance sheet. If we get the net loss, we are supposed to deduct it from the capital account in the balance sheet. So now let us see the format of profit and loss account. So just like a trading account, profit and loss account has two sides, particular debit side and credit side. Debit side with two columns, particulars amount, and credit side with two columns, particulars and amount. Dear students, please do remember that debit side is meant to record all kinds of indirect expenses and losses. I'm repeating, in the debit side you are supposed to enter all indirect expenses and losses, whereas in the credit side all incomes and the means all indirect incomes and the gross profit. The very first step in the profit and loss account is to enter the result of trading account. Say for example, the result of trading account is gross profit. In trading account, gross profit is taken on the debit side, but when it is brought down to the profit and loss account, it has to be entered on the credit side, that is by gross profit brought down. In the same manner, if the result of the trading account is gross loss, so in trading account gross loss is taken on the credit side, but when it is brought down to the profit and loss account, it is entered on the debit side. So the very first transaction in the profit and loss account is to record the result of the trading account. Thereafter, you are supposed to enter all indirect expenses or losses on the debit side. We will see one by one. First one is salaries, means salaries which is payable to the office staff. It is an indirect expense, so the entry is to salaries. Next one is to rent, rates and taxes, any rent payable towards the building, so it is an indirect expenses, hence we have taken on the debit side. Other charges which is payable through the office, such as to office expenses, lighting and heating, printing, stationery, postage, telegrams and telephone charges, all such expenses are indirect, which are paid through the office, hence we are taking it as a indirect expenses on the debit side. Next one is the insurance payable on any plant and machinery or on the building, it is also in indirect expenses, so the entry is to insurance. Next one is a legal charges, to audit fees, to repairs, so repairs of the plant and machinery, repairs of the building. Next one is a depreciation, so depreciation is nothing but reducing in the value of the asset. Say for example, I have purchased the plant and machinery in 2015. After 5 years, the value of such plant and machinery has reduced. That reduction in the value, reduced value, is a loss to the business, hence I am taking it as a indirect expenses on the debit side. Next one, interest paid. So any interest paid on the loan borrowed, it is a expenses, so I am taking it on the debit side. Then to discount allowed, to whom we can give the discount, to our debtors. So any discount given to the debtors, it is a loss for the business, so that loss is taken on the debit side. Next one is to bad debts, very important adjustment. So bad debts, whenever the goods are sold on the credit basis, means in case of credit sales, as you all know that there are two types of sales, cash sales and the credit sales. This bad debts arises only in case of credit sales. Say for example, I have sold goods worth rupees 20,000 to customer on credit basis, but the customer has paid only 15,000, but he fails to pay remaining 5,000 because by that time he became insolvent. In such a case, that whatever that amount which is irrecoverable during the year, then such expenses is treated as a bad debts because it is a loss. It is a loss. Next one is a commission paid, any commission paid or any carriage outwards. So carriage inwards is a direct expenses, so we have taken it in the trading account. Whereas the carriage outwards is the selling expenses, hence we are entering the same entry in the profit and loss account. Next, traveling expenses. To interest on capital. So capital is nothing but is an investment made by the owner. For that investment, we are supposed to pay the interest to the owner. So that is also an expense. So I am taking that interest on capital on the debit side of the profit and loss account. These are the some of the adjustment or the expenses supposed to be taken under the indirect expenses. Next, on the incomes. So all incomes or profits are entered on the credit side of the profit and loss account along with the gross profit brought down. The first one is the rent received. So if you have received any rent from the let out property, then that acts as an income, hence we are going to credit it. Next one is a buy commission received. Commission paid is an expense, whereas commission received is an income. So I have taken that commission received on the credit side. Next one is a discount received. Discount given to the debtors is a expenses, whereas discount received from the creditors is a income. Say for example, the creditors has given the discount of rupees 2000 where you are supposed to pay, for example 10,000 you are supposed to pay, but he has given only 2000 as a discount. So your balance 8000 is payable towards any payment. Next one is bad debts recovered. Say for example, during the previous year, if there is any bad debts of rupees 5000, but out of 5000 in the current year, the customer has paid or the debtor has paid rupees 1000. That 1000 acts as an income, so I am going to take it on the credit side. And the last one is the interest received. So interest received from any loan given to our employees or to anybody, such interest is treated as an income. These are the some of the examples which are covered under the credit side of the profit and loss account. I'm repeating, the first transaction is a gross profit or gross loss, and the second transaction is a recording all indirect expenses on the debit side, and the third transaction recording all indirect incomes on the credit side. After that, we have to balance the profit and loss account just to know the net profit or net loss for the current year. In order to ascertain the net profit or net loss, first we have to take the total of both the sides. Say for example, the total of the credit side is 5 lakh, whereas the total of the debit side is just 3 lakh 50 thousand. At that time, the higher side total is taken on both the side, that is 5 lakh. So then, as the credit side is more than the debit side, means credit side is meant to record all incomes and profits. So income is more than the expenses, at that time the result is a net profit. In case if debit side is more than the credit side, means if expenses is more than the income, then the result is net loss. Whatever the result, it is finally transferred to capital account while preparing the balance sheet. So this is all about the format of profit and loss account. Thank you.